All right, here we go. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. What up, y'all? Welcome to Here's the Thing. I'm Kev on stage. She's
that chick angel.
Welcome to another podcast episode. Smash that like button. Smash that notification button. Make sure you get notified when the podcast is up. Join the gang over at patreon.kevonstagestudios.com. Join the Kev on Stage Studios.
Bow, bow, bow.
Wherever
bow,
you get waka, your
flocka,
app.
Waka, flocka.
Quick announcement.
What's the announcement, Kevin?
Bobby Shmurda's home.
Oh, and so is the hat.
Bing, bing, bing. You know who Bobby Shmurda is?
Yeah, he was a rapper. He was in jail.
Bobby home, Angel.
Oh, yeah.
Shmoney, one of the few dances that I don't look ridiculous doing, is back.
Shmoney time.
Shmoney time?
Why he looks so delicate? He looks like he could break it any time. He looks so delicate.
Bobby's home, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah.
You see all the memes with the hat flying in?
The Thor entrance, which is one of the best scenes in cinema history, with the New York cap. Funny that he's one of the first rappers that was introduced to me via a meme. The first thing I saw Bobby Shmurda is when he threw that hat and did the Shmoney dance, but it was to a Kirk Franklin song.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't even know he was a rapper. And I saw probably 4 or 5 memes before I ever actually realized, wait, he actually had a, because he was hippie. Mm-hmm. You know, it was an interesting dance for him to be, the dance plus the rap content did not line up.
It didn't line up for you.
The dance was joyful. Mm-hmm. It was hip-centric. He was like, kill, 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 grrr, shut up. I was like, okay. Hey,
what? We can end it there.
What happened?
You threw me off on this. I just want you to know. I'm still trying to gain my balance.
That wasn't in the docket.
It wasn't. And I was like going through my head, Bobby Shmurda, did he sell champagne? No, he did. Does he do heroin? Bobby Shmurda, though. Yep, here, there. I'm here.
All right.
Here's the thing.
Okay, that wasn't in the doc. I just saw that this on the way in. Okay, so what's really starting our episode?
Tell him. Got me over here looking stay back.
A Columbia professor. This is the headline, guys. Columbia professor who's black. I do heroin regularly for work-life balance.
Mm-hmm.
A little hair on.
That, I feel like, is called addiction. If it is what is making you balance, it is an addiction.
Angel, he's not a dick. It's just a little hair on.
It's a little something. Take the edge off.
Just a little.
You know, just
a little bit of that horse.
Hold on, but see, he's not injecting. He is sniffing.
I know, but I mean, heroin. Tony has a great joke on this. He says heroin has the worst entry of all the drugs. To have to do the tie off.
Yeah, that's a lot.
And then first of all, a lot of great jazz music was made because of heroin. A lot of great music, period. Mm-hmm. Back in the 60s, 70s, mm-hmm. You know, Ray was on that horse.
Yeah.
He was on that horse. Mm-hmm. You know, he was, I got a woman. Little hair on.
Little me.
Oh, yeah. Have you ever heard my Ray Charles impersonation?
No, let me see it. Let me see it.
One of my best. Well, I got a woman. Way over town. That good to be. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
All right, Kev.
Bobby Shmurda. He's out.
Way over Melissa was like, can you stop doing the race? It doesn't sound like what you...
I was like, okay, he's trying.
The straight jacket arms. That was what was killing
good
me.
Good to me.
Good morning.
Oh, yeah. To see my baby.
Uh-huh. Okay.
You're doing it, Kev.
Jamie Foxx have several seats.
Jamie Foxx, Eric Bishop, I'm coming for you. Hulk Hogan, I'm coming for you, nigga. Have you seen that?
Yes. Yes.
Booker T looked at the white girl like, am I fired?
It is one of the best clips.
He was so into character. Yes. Hulk Hogan. We're coming for you, nigga. Oh, he's white. He's like, oh my God.
Were you rolling?
The white girl was like,
I didn't say it.
Not this time.
Right. You didn't catch me. That thing.
This, you know, that job is gone. Oh, man. Was this live? This was live?
We can't take it back? Yeah.
Whole arena saw? Oh, no.
was just like,
dang.
Because Booker T was the bigger of the Harlem Heat.
Yeah.
So if Booker gone, you know Stevie Ray, he out
he's gone. Yeah, he's like, well.
Stevie Ray like, well, I can do long haul trucking. I could do security. I could be a bouncer.
That's about it. That's about it.
But anyway, Carl Hart, who is a Columbia professor, he's open about his drug use, saying his whole thing is he's saying substances such as heroin should not be criminalized.
Uh-huh.
Or like, what's the other word he used?
Demonized. Demonized, yeah.
Demonized. And he said basically his point is like, a little heroin ain't never hurt nobody.
That's pretty much his point. And I'm like, while I do get... I do think that the usage of drugs should be decriminalized.
All drugs?
Yeah, pretty much. Okay. Yeah. I think the trafficking, the intent to sell, all that. Yeah, keep it where it's at. But people who are using drugs, I don't feel like the criminal system does anything to prevent them from further using drugs.
I agree with that.
That's the reason why I'm like, if our criminal system is set up to be able to correct and then rehabilitate people, it is not going to do that for someone who is using drugs. So what's the...
Especially someone who's addicted to drugs.
Exactly. And a lot of times their circumstance as far as in their economic status play a lot into them becoming addicts. Yeah. So if the government is not going to fix that, then you can't really be punishing people for a situation that they really didn't put themselves in.
You know, we went to Amsterdam and drugs are... decriminalized there.
Uh-huh.
So, you know the little gift shops at like, you know, you forget your toothpaste or you want a postcard. We were walking down the street. They sell ecstasy, heroin, cocaine, LSD, and then like Colgate and Coke.
Do they sell crack too? Is crack not a thing there?
And they sell crack. They had cocaine though.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember walking past the thing because I knew drugs were legal in Amsterdam, but I didn't know they were sold at like essentially 7-Eleven.
Yeah.
Not everyone. Actually, it's more like a smoke shop.
Uh-huh.
More like a smoke shop than a 7-Eleven.
A novelty store.
A novelty store. But they also, this particular one did sell toothpaste and Coke and like souvenirs as well. Uh-huh. I mean, Coca-Cola.
Mm-hmm.
And
not what
cocaine.
Weekends.
Right. And apparently Amsterdam has very low violent crime. The thing in America, they're like, if you decriminalize drugs, you're gonna have an uptick in violent crime.
Right.
And to your point, a lot of scholars have written about this and talked about this, and there's a whole season of The Wire about this.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's called New Amsterdam, I believe, where Bunny Colvin was like, bro, what if we just section off a piece of the city and be like, y'all wanna do drugs, do it here.
Mm-hmm.
And at the same time, we will have free healthcare clinics and pass out clean needles, and we'll see. Because he was basically like, we are wasting so many resources taking the drug dealers, throwing away, locking up the druggies.
Yeah.
It's just, you know, we're not policing.
Uh-huh.
We're just throwing people in jail. They're getting out. They're doing, like, it's a wasted effort. So Bunny Colvin, it was great in The Wire. And I think, if I'm not mistaken, it was based on somebody trying to do that for real.
Uh-huh.
But then there was a murder.
And things go bad.
And then people, and he also did it off the books. But anyway, I think, to your point, the criminalization of drugs... well, this is a point people have made. Heroin, tobacco, alcohol, coffee, not very different.
Right, as far as their addictive properties?
As far as their addictive properties. Now, obviously, being addicted to caffeine doesn't lead to crime in the way that being addicted to crack will. Now, on that same point, I want us to watch this Reagan documentary. I've been avoiding it because I got to sparse out my black trauma videos.
Oh, okay.
And I had over-indexed for a while.
Okay.
But anyway, it was talking about how, like, when you're addicted to crack, what you'll do to get more crack isn't the same thing with alcohol.
Mm-hmm.
But to their point, violent crime would actually go down if it was decriminalized. The government would make more money if it could tax this stuff legally.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I've heard? The reason they don't do it? Off-the-books stuff made with drug money is too important to the government.
Mm-hmm.
To legally tax it.
I can believe that.
I can too.
Yeah, that sounds just about right. Like, it's, I feel like money laundering allows you to be able to put your hands in things that no one should know that you have your hands in.
Yes.
So if you're using tax dollars to have your hands in something grimy, people are going to be like, no, what you doing?
You got to put that on the book.
Right. Well, why are you doing that? Where if you have dirty money that has to be clean, you can't tell where it came from. You can be into a bunch of stuff that the American people would find unsavory.
Yes. Which is, if you watch Snowfall, right?
Of course.
Okay. If you haven't watched Snowfall, it's a storybook course in how some stuff the CIA wants to do, they need drug money for.
Yeah.
And so here a little bit of drugs, sell it to the blacks.
Right.
We're going to arrest you too, though.
Yes.
But with that money, we're going to overthrow somebody in Guatemala.
Exactly.
You know, like, and that's how the sausage is made in the United States of America.
That's not, so this professor, he does cocaine, I mean, not cocaine.
Heronnnn.
Heronnnn to relax in his day. It helps him like refocus, reset to start a new day. Mm-hmm. What is the craziest thing that you would be willing to do to
relax?
Yeah, like
to start your day off.
Or not craziest. What do you feel like you need to do to?
I play FIFA.
FIFA helps you?
FIFA on that Nintendo Switch. I'm the best player. Well, not now because I started a new career, but I be killing in FIFA. You all right?
I was hoping the seat could go higher, but it don't. Go ahead. Okay.
I play a lot of FIFA. I watch a lot of television and ice cream.
And ice cream.
You had Jenny's ice cream make me feel.
Huh?
You had Jenny's ice cream?
I have had Jenny's splendid ice cream. How do you relax?
I like to watch trash TV.
Yes. Married at First Sight.
The Bachelor. All of that.
Oh, you see them crying last night?
Oh, he just kept crying in
Why
his tight
women
pants.
Why keep telling him no? He like, I tell you, no.
You can't leave me. You can't leave me.
The whole thing.
It's me. I'm the Bachelor. I ain't never seen a show where he's the prize. And this is like the second or maybe third woman who left him.
They were like, what I'm not about to do is get dumped by a black dude on national TV. That's what is not about to happen. I'll be out before that even happens. So sorry. So yeah, trash TV. I used to like to like write out my thoughts. I don't have that time anymore. Like there's something about like pen to paper or something. Like even when we were doing the I can't wait till y'all see this, the Real Comedians Challenge thing, when we were getting to like do the sketches painting of ourselves.
Yeah.
That was so nice. It was so relaxing.
It was very relaxing. It was oddly therapeutic.
It was so therapeutic. I'm pretty sure that's how the people at Paint Your Life feel when their artists are making things for the customers. They are probably feeling really therapeutic. And it's also that you can give a wonderful gift to a loved one or have something in your own collection. Now, I am not a great painter. Neither is Kevin. We shouldn't give gifts to people if they want to think or we shouldn't give paintings to people that we've done if people want to think that we love them. But what we could do is give a painting or a picture to Paint Your Life, and then they will have a team of world-class artists that we get to choose from and work with until every detail is perfect. They will actually take that picture, and they can actually combine pictures to make a custom-made hand-painted portrait in less than 5 minutes. You can order it, and it comes back in about 3 weeks.
Yep.
Kevin, how many do you have now?
I have three now. I have one of me and Melissa. I got one of the boys, and I got one of all four of us.
Aww.
And they're all going in my office at the new soundstage. They're actually already in there. They just haven't been put up there.
So you didn't even get it as a gift to anybody?
To myself.
So you could do that. It could be a gift to your own self. However you want it, having a beautiful painted portrait is something that you just don't get. You can't just get that anywhere. But Paint Your Life has made it possible for you to be able to have something very special and very important to you. So this is what we would like for you to do. We would like you to go to paintyourlife.com. where there's no risk. If you don't love the final painting, your money is refunded, guaranteed. And now, as a limited time offer, get 20% off your painting. That's right, 20% off and free shipping. Mm-hmm. To get this special offer, text the word SK to 64,000. That's SK to 64,000. Terms apply, available at paintyourlife.com/terms. Again, text keyword 64,000, y'all. That's what you're going to put in there to SK.
Having too much fun with his new brother-in-law, man.
Knives Brothers. That one was a little clunky, but I got it in there. That's all that matters. I was like, we talking about drugs, paintings. It's a lot. I mean,
you did your best.
I did.
I didn't see it coming.
Yeah. Oh, you said what?
I didn't see it coming, the painting. I was like, how are you going to do this? And then you did this. By the way, let me.
Is that painting bothering you?
Yes. I saw when it came, I felt I saw it, when coming. It came down. It was like a huge Friday. Train.
Look over that angel. I'd be like, bro, why are you over
there? Why are you over
there? Also, angel.
What's up?
Not only does he do hair on, he snorts bath salts.
Oh, I didn't even see that in the article. He says he
very bottom. He even found pleasure in snorting a version of so-called bath salts, a synthetic cathinone that's been linked to disturbing behavior from barking to breaking into homes.
This man is a drug addict.
His assessment, unequivocally wonderful. He recounts the effects as being euphoric and energetic, clear-headed and highly social. Nice. Literally, the nice has like seven eyes.
Yeah.
Bath salts?
No.
Bath salts.
That makes you hallucinate.
Yes. Like, remember bath salts era? People in Florida were like biting people. And
yes.
Like,
they were like zombies. Like, yeah, no, I'm sorry. Now, I already know I don't have the brain to deal with hard drugs. I don't have it. It's not, my brain is not here for it. Mm-hmm. I took a Valium, okay, after they gave me a half of one after I got my Lasix. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
After I got my LASIK, I was not married at the time, but I was dating Marcus. I was out here in Orange County. He was in Kentucky. My mother was in the bed with me. I was on the phone with him, and I somehow fell in that place of between sleep and awake, where my mind is awake, but my body ain't.
Yeah.
And I can barely move my mouth. And I was like, Marcus, I might have to fall asleep for a second, and then I'm going to hurry up and wake up. Because I couldn't figure out how to get out of it. So I fell asleep, and then I jolted myself awake and ran into a wall.
Really?
That is what happened on a half a pill of Valium.
So you probably didn't take another one.
Angel would be naked in the street.
Yes.
If she took hard drugs.
Oh, my God.
Coming in!
All over the place. Ran into a wall. About to lose my mind. Wishing that this half a pill would just, I wanted to piss it out. I was like, how can I get it out of my body? My brain can't do it. You know, maybe he has the brain of a person that can handle drugs. I am not.
I don't want to do that drugs. I don't. Here's the thing that's interesting, though. Right. To his point, in the Air Force, I believe, fighter pilots have to take what are called flight packs, which I believe have Adderall in them. And I believe taking Adderall without a prescription is a drug, but a lot of I don't know if they're called a lot of people take Adderall to be more focused.
Yeah, that's what I'll be watching Grownish.
Yep.
And they were all, that's what all the kids in school were doing. They were popping them Adderall pills so they could get through their term papers.
Yeah.
Transparency. I had a week of an Adderall.
Do tell.
Joshua.
Trying up. I wasn't going crazy.
You did a drugs?
It was literally during my finals week. This is when I was working two jobs because I was all deaf in that PacSun. And then I was like, I'm not finna do this college stuff.
Really?
It's not going to get done.
Were you out there selling your body for drugs, Josh?
Absolutely not. I tried. I literally tried it. It was I tried it twice.
Oh no.
And that was it. I was
are a hardened criminal.
I know. I didn't snort it though.
Did you just pop it?
People be doing the Adderalls.
You does put it in your mouth and drink it with orange juice? What'd you do?
No. So apparently, I guess at the time, they tell you not to do orange juice.
Where's the Joshy Cam?
Oh, that makes sense.
I know.
I know. I had tried it because I was like, look, I mean, it was like a small half of a half because I was just like, let me just see what he's talking about, man.
Man.
Was it helpful?
This is the Kevon State Studios, a drug rehabilitation center for wayward criminals.
For wayward criminals.
Nah, but I mean, like, I don't know. It literally felt like coffee times two. For me, because of the minor, it wasn't a crazy dose, but it was just.
I just picture him out here, nothing, just his gold chain, just scratching, no shirt on, just
Listen, boy. Them people at All Deaf Angel, they was doing drugs.
Oh, I absolutely did not assume anything but that.
I was like, yo, I remember in Washington, First of all, I wouldn't even know where to get a weeds from in Washington.
These people
were doing cocaine at work.
At work. Literally.
In the bathroom. Literally.
Yeah.
I've never saw it. I saw the like, oh, no, no.
No, I saw it on somebody's computer one time. I was like, wow. And they were like,
wow.
Key bumps out of the bath. I saw the effects a couple of times. Like, yo, what is your man on? And somebody else would be like,
he's on the book of sugar.
Literally. And I mean, literally, like how Donald Trump's son be looking on TV. I'm like, yo, y'all be chewing now. And the parties from what I hear.
Oh, they just doing it all.
Drogas.
I remember the first time I bought the weeds. It wasn't for me. It was for people who came in town. It was in Kentucky. And they came in town on a, they were on a musical theater tour. And I had done theater with them before. And they called me because they were in Kentucky. That's where the tour stopped. And they were like, Angel, do you know where we can get some of the weeds? And I was like, I'm sure some of my friends do the weeds. Of course. I'll find out. So I called one of my homegirl. And she was like, yeah, I'm going to give you the number to the dude that I buy from. Turns out, the dude that sells it, I used to teach acting classes to.
Oh, no.
And so we meet up at a hotel, and I was like, where's my money? I was like, okay. So how much is it? How much is it? Here you go. Can I have it? He was like, this is in Kentucky. Weed is not legalized at all there. I was like, is it 20? Do you have change? You have change. Do you take credit card? Here's the monies. He was just like,
where is my receipt? I have to write this off as a prop purchase for Angel, that chick Angel LLC Enterprises.
And he gave it to me. I was just like, okay, this is all we get. Is this it? This is it though.
How much did you buy?
Like a bag of it, like a little baggie.
A little dub sack of weed.
That's what it looked like.
Was it Reggie or was it a loud pack?
I don't know what that means.
You know, Reggie Bowl, just like a little bit of regular, not, you know, it's not too serious. But that loud, we smoking that gas, you feel me?
Nope.
We smoking gas. That's indica.
Now, that's what I smoked was sativa. Indica.
Which one is the relaxer, Josh?
Indica.
Indica, so I hear.
Indica is the
sativa relaxer. Is the loud patch.
Sativa's, well, it's supposed to be indica is the one that like makes you slump. Sativa, it's supposed to let you be more creative.
Yes.
So sativa is the loud pack.
If that's what you want to call it. I smoked the indica.
And that's when you had good angel and evil angel?
That's when it wasn't good and evil. It was rational and special. Special angel. She was a special, special little girl. So special. That's what she was. She's the type you got to watch when she around the toilets because she might be in there playing in there. She's a special girl. Oh, yeah. Yes, but I'm not the one. If you want to be cool, you want to do the drugs, you want to be, you know, stealth.
A D.A.R.E. commercial.
If you want to do all that, I'm not going to be the friend that is going to be cool with you. I'm going to make it look like the most stupidest thing ever.
Somebody said Angel bought her drugs and asked for a receipt and have it notarized.
Yes.
Here's my license. I want to just mark me down as a drugs buyer, please. And you know, I got the book. Stamp it. Photocopy that. Yes. Mail it to my house.
Absolutely.
So we can make sure you know I bought the drug.
What is your return policy?
Are you a police officer? Yes. No, I did take the drugs.
I did. We were in the hotel lobby. I was like, I remember you. I didn't know who they were talking about. I said, so you sell the drugs?
Man.
He was like, yeah, how you been? I'm thinking, well, I've been good.
The funniest thing about this picture, Angel, is you got to put the picture right here, Josh.
Okay.
He's in the thing. He's like, what?
Right.
I do a little hair on. It never hurt nobody. Y'all, who amongst us ain't done a little hair on a bath salt?
I feel like that he's going to be like somebody who does that is the same person that just tries anything and is just like, oh, it doesn't mean anything. Yeah. I put his penis in my mouth once. I just gave it a try. That's what that feels like.
I do want. I've actually thought about this.
Putting a penis in your mouth?
No, no, no.
You came in.
You came out of that. You came in hot on that one. Actually, I thought.
You know what?
I would have. If y'all would have let me finish my sentence, I would have finished.
We did. We literally let you finish.
We gave you half a second.
Listen, just listen. Let me clarify, because I don't want to get that part cut out and put on the reels. Now everybody's like, I knew. He was too happy. He loved his sons. Something was off.
Something. Go ahead.
I've thought about, okay, God created us for sex, you know, boom, P and the G. And then somebody was like, hey, let me turn around. Let's try it like this. Who was the first person the Bible was like, what if I put that in my mouth, though? And somebody had to try it first.
Mm-hmm.
Like, oh, man, we've been doing a lot of this. What if I lick it, though?
It was.
Oh. You know what I'm saying? Like, did that thought just pop? Like, who was that? Abimelech?
I can tell you what happened.
Tell me what happened. Who was the first peen sucked in the Bible?
It was the first menstrual cycle.
That was it.
That actually makes a lot of sense.
I can't. I'm bleeding. You know what?
You know what ain't bleeding.
Hear me out.
Hear me out.
That's where butt stuff came from.
Mm.
You got, okay, one hole out of commission, week or so.
Yeah.
Okay. Two holes available. Mouth.
What did that thing do?
Butt. That was it.
That's what happened.
I think it was, who was Solomon? Well, it couldn't be Solomon because Solomon had more than one woman. You were on cycle. And man, he had all them women living in the house.
Yeah,
there. All the cycles combined.
It was Adam and Eve. They got that.
You think it was Adam?
I think it's been going on since the beginning
of
time.
You think Adam got that pizza?
Right behind the tree in the garden.
I can't.
He already naked.
I'm not doing this.
Oh, that's the serpent. I got the snake.
I'm not doing this with y'all.
Why not, Josh? God created sex for. Oh, you do Adderall, but you don't want to.
I know
you
that's what you got. Just
do Adderall and just think about what your mind should do.
Exactly.
But seeing who got the first pee sucked in the Bible is where you draw the line.
Yeah.
Had to be Adam.
Judging. That's what
I
think.
He was naked, girl. What would have had the burning bush?
Yes, she had a little taste of that fruit.
Wait, but Eve didn't have period at first. Until she got cursed because she ate that fruit. Then God was like. Periods.
Yeah.
And Adam was like, listen, you bit the apple.
Right. And she was turned after that. She was like, all the haste pop, yo, like this. Shake your body, don't stop. No, quick, come on, Adam. Then. Just do it. That's how God found them when they were hiding. He was like, stop twerking so loud.
Just grabbing the fruit.
Eve started listening to City Girls.
Yes. City Girls. Yeah. He's going to hear us. He can't hear us.
Delilah was a city girl.
Of course. But shit, most of these dudes were city girls first.
JT. That's Delilah. Oh, she like, oh, you want to take my home? That's my whole flow. That's Delilah, social bar.
Yeah.
That's my whole flow. Taking a strong man. I cut his brains off. He stole my whole flow.
Whole flow. That's what they were. I listen.
Whole menstrual flow.
Whole menstrual flow.
Stop. Don't sip your coffee right after you say that joke.
It had to be Adam. Adam ate the first coochie? Mm-hmm.
What? Oh, yeah. Yeah, I mean, when your eyes are open, your eyes are open.
He probably bit that apple and was like.
You think she immediately learned how to twerk like? When she bit the apple?
For sure.
It just like overpowered. Oh. The spirit was overpowered.
What? It's like it. What? Yeah. That's why Adam ate it after that. He was doing whatever she asked. Go ahead, eat it. Mm-mm-mm. Go ahead, eat it. Yeah. Absolutely.
They're just having good old missionary sex.
Missionary sex. Oh, gosh. Oh, this is a great organ. Oh, plentiful of the earth.
And they bit that apple. He was like, flip it, turn it over, girl. I'm going to tie it to this tree. Turn upside down. Open your butt. Lick that. Boom. I'm going to spin you around on my meat. You hold my balls. Jiggle them. Bow. Okay?
Jiggle
I'm
around.
I'm going to throw you in the tree. Boom. Damn. You come off. Land on my balls. Okay. Yeah. Then you throw me in the garden. Let's go in the river. You go. I'm going to lick your butt in the river. And God was like, okay, y'all got to put clothes on. This is like, y'all lost.
That's the only way he got them to stop was he gave her cramps. He was like, stop. I'm trying to talk to y'all. Yeah, are y'all finished yet? And he's like, you know what? I'm going to have to tear up your whole uterus real quick. And she was like, man, hold on. This don't feel good no more. I got the runs. I got to stop. This is not going to work. She's like, this is, God, this hurts so bad. I need a pill. We got some Tylenol. We got anything. Adam, you got something. You got a vitamin or something. You got some ritual in your pocket.
That's probably what she.
And we ritual for spot.
Oh! Angel! Angel! You transitioned that into a ritual act?
I did.
You did?
I did. And you know, just like Eve deserves to know what's in her vitamins, so do we. All right?
To hear. You just don't ever disrespect the goat again. Don't ever disrespect the goat. You be in this studio, you need to listen to the goat.
Ritual is a vegan-friendly, clean multivitamin, and it's formulated with high-quality nutrients and is bioavailable, and which forms your body can actually use. Because when you're putting synthetics and whatnots in your body don't know what the heck that is. So that's why it's so fantastic that Ritual has a vitamin that your body actually knows what's all in it and how to process and use it. So I know that Melissa and Kev, they be on that Ritual.
Listen, that's the only way I get through some of these days. Mm-hmm. To get in the morning, okay, let me get my workout, shower, breakfast, Ritual, start my day. Especially heavy shoot weeks like this.
Yeah.
It's more important to get my routine going. Because otherwise, you know what it's like, Angel. You start shooting early call times. Your whole week be thrown off. Next thing you know, you're eating pizza for breakfast. You don't know what happened.
You don't know what happened. And I'm going to tell you, to be honest, I feel like when you have a really dope vitamin like Ritual, it does give you the type of energy and focus you need to get through the day.
Yep.
Because your body is really being fueled with the things it needs to be able to focus, to be able to perform at its best capability. So now available for women, men, and teens, Ritual multivitamins are scientifically developed to help support different life stages. Your multivitamin can be delivered to your door every month with free shipping always. You can start, snooze, or cancel your subscription at any time. And if you don't love Ritual within your first month, they'll refund your first order. Okay. Get your key nutrients without the BS. Ritual is offering our listeners 10% off during the first 3 months. Visit ritual.com/crew to start your ritual today. Again, Ritual is offering, here's the thing, listeners, 10% off during their first 3 months. Visit ritual.com/crew to start your ritual today. That's K-R-E-W. And when you're putting good vitamins in your body, it's also important to put good foods in your body as well. And that is why we are also excited to have HelloFresh.
HelloFresh.
Sponsoring this podcast. What I love about HelloFresh is that you're getting just really quality ingredients pre-measured. Okay, the recipes are all there for you already. You don't have to do all this planning and guesswork. If you're somebody like me that's constantly being creative, constantly having to produce content, not just produce it, come up with it, then do the creative direction. The last thing I want to do is creative direct the meal that my family eats at the end of the day.
It's too much energy, Andrew.
Too much energy. And I am not at the place in life where I'm about to spend a lot of money on a chef. So, but what I can spend money on is HelloFresh, okay? Because you're eating healthier and you're eating low carb, low-cal, you can have vegetarian, you can have pescatarian. You have so many options that you can choose from. And every recipe is packed with fresh produce sourced directly from farmers. Mm-hmm. They also offer 23-plus recipes each week featuring a range of flavors, cuisine, and ingredients so that you'll never get bored. And HelloFresh is America's number one meal kit. So I'm going to tell you right now, me being a mother of four boys, okay? Me being a host on, here's the thing, a host on Is This Gonna Cause an Argument, as well as a producer on that show, producing all my content and stuff. I want to be able to eat good and not worry about what I'm going to be eating. And HelloFresh does exactly that. All right, so this is what we want to do.
What y'all
want to
do?
We want you to go to HelloFresh.com/10SK.
10SK, Kev.
And use the code 10SK.
10SK.
For 10 free meals. What? Including free shipping.
Hey, girl.
Wait a minute. I'm going to tell you one more time. Go to HelloFresh.com/10SK.
10SK.
Use the code 10SK.
10SK.
For 10 free meals, including free shipping. What is going on here, guys?
What's going on?
Okay. America's. This is HelloFresh, America's number one meal kit. And we thank him for sponsoring this podcast.
Boom shakalaka. By the way, Young Deuces just said this in the chat, and I love it. He said, I feel a crew coming on. A crew coming on. I feel a crew coming on. A crew coming on. Crew, 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 crew.
Yeah.
Crew beat coming. Crew beat coming. Crew beat coming. Crew beat coming. If you don't know that song, you are probably Joshua's age.
Yes.
And born sometime in the 90s.
Yes.
93 when Joshua was born.
I'll let you rock, Kev.
Third grade when
9/11.
You shouldn't even be having your own house to live in. Somebody better tuck you in at night, little baby.
Little baby.
Anyway, next topic for the Lord Strikes Us Down. Jay-Z.
Ooh. That's hope.
Sean Carter. He's having a good week.
He's having a fantastic week.
His mother-in-law, Miss Tina Lawson, mm-hmm. wrote a pretty long Instagram post.
Yeah.
And we'll just summarize it here.
Uh-huh.
As I believe it was Boosie's daughter said, told y'all, niggas. Mm-hmm. Miss Tina Lawson was like, remember when y'all said Jay-Z working for the Super Bowl, he was a sellout, mm-hmm. and he wasn't going to do nothing from the inside. We're going to tear down the system. He booked The Weeknd.
He did.
He got Jasmine Sullivan on
him
there.
Did.
He got her on there.
Him did.
I didn't say he was a sellout. I was one of the people, not the few, but a lot of people said, let me see what he does before I judge, which was I.
Mm-hmm.
I thought when Jasmine Sullivan and her were on the opening of the Super Bowl, I was like, man, mm-hmm. those are some black artists.
Black.
To be on the Super Bowl, yeah. the anthem, and the Star Spangled Banner,
mm-hmm.
I was really surprised. Because Jasmine Sullivan, she's huge to us. She's not huge
No.
to white America. Her as well.
Right.
They are not humongous stars to the whole America.
Yes.
You're going to get you a Kelly Clarkson, Carrie Underwood,
mm-hmm.
Taylor Swift. Like,
yeah.
there was a couple years there where we got there. I was like, okay. we got punished for Janet Jackson enough.
Yeah.
Bruce Springsteen. Like, okay, come on. The Eagles. I mean, I'm not serious, but it was a couple years there where I was like, okay, how many years y'all going to punish us? Because you're punishing everybody.
Mm-hmm.
It was like the whole class didn't get to go to the pizza party because of Justin Timberlake. Okay, so that was his one thing.
Uh-huh.
Then he sold Ace of Spades, which apparently is called Armand.
Yeah, it had a different name, but he rebranded it.
He rebranded it as Ace of Spades.
Did you mm-hmm. see that profit margin?
Josh.
Jesus.
$30 million. he purchased Ace of Spades for $30 million, I want to say 5 years ago?
I'm looking.
5 to 7 years ago.
Mm.
Sold half of it.
Just half. He still
Joshua,
has half.
To Louis Vuitton Moet Hennessy, which also, very interesting that Louis Vuitton, the luxury clothing brand, is the same company that sells Moet and Hennessy.
I can't believe it.
Like LVMH or LVHM. I don't know.
Listen.
Half of something he spent $30 million on mm-hmm. is now worth $250
million.
Mm-hmm. And he still owns the other half. Joshua is always telling us, I've used title before, but I'm not a titler. He's like, look, quality of sound better. I do know they pay their artists more. Mm. And they actually have, remember we used to look through the CD to get the album notes, who wrote the song and stuff. I actually used to really enjoy.
I love it. I still buy actual CDs.
Do you really?
If I really love the artist, I'm buying the
album. You just have it to hold?
Yeah, I don't. I use my phone to usually listen to it, but really? I love the art on the like. If an artist is doing the whole shebang, which is like somebody like Beyonce, she's going to do a whole dope photo shoot just for that thing.
I used to love flipping through the.
It's the best.
Sometimes it have the lyrics in there.
Now, yes! Oh, come on, the lyrics. Mm. Oh,
that's probably one of the things I miss the most about physical CDs.
I don't remember any of this. I was born in 93.
I was going to say, what are you talking about? Yeah. First of all,
I don't even know how
you never played no tape.
I have. I have a.
You do it for the.
Are you doing it to be a hipster?
Yes.
On cassette, I got A Reasonable Doubt.
That's solely to be a hipster. Come on now.
I'm nowhere.
You don't know what it's like to hold.
Yes, you are.
A radio to a radio.
In one hand.
To make a.
Try and time the. With the.
Yeah.
He's being slick.
He is.
He's being sarcastic.
He really
he's
is.
He's sick of it. I think he's sick of us, Angel.
I'm not. He I'm is. Just
he's a millennial, too. He's a baby millennial.
And then when you play it too much, man, you know the thing just be, you know, you don't
want to.
Oh! That's the worst. That's
are you a millennial?
I don't know.
Are you
know
at the tail end?
I think I might.
I know we've had this conversation before. I think me and you were in, and then Angel was a baby boomer.
That's not true.
The point is, Angel, I don't want to get another hairline joke. Just let me get that one out. Okay. Because I know it, two jokes and then she fires back. She'll get you away with
she
one.
She started that car. She's like, oh, I'm.
Yeah.
I was like,
but okay. Anyway, I really used to enjoy that. Yes. Uh-huh. I also remember, okay, I want to talk about music. I want to ask you guys a question. It's way Please. On the docket anyway.
Go ahead, go ahead.
I remember in my car having the 4-pack CD with the album
yes.
cover CD. Album, and yes. like you get in somebody's car, you flip through, like, okay,
see what you got here. Oh, you
got some stuff. And then at the back for me, burnt CDs. That yes, back of half. Course.
Oh, yeah.
Because after a while, I was in college, I was like,
marker written on there. This is Jay-Z, Unreasonable Doubt. Put that
was
in
a
there.
Second there, when I was in college, I was like, is this $15?
It's a lot.
Napster was like, also, it's free.
It's free.
You are going to destroy your computer getting this album.
But worry about that later. You'll buy a new computer.
Don't worry about it. I still had my Corolla. That was something that was stolen out of my car, was my collection.
Oh.
My thick CD. That in a Bible.
That's a different level.
Steal the car. Leave that.
Leave that. They took the Bible and the music.
The Bible?
They took my Bible.
Out of your car?
You know
out of
my car. They probably needed it more. They probably needed to find Jesus.
I said, I
you
hope.
You steal a Bible is really... That's kind of like
that's pretty
and
dark.
The Christian in me should have been like, well, hopefully, Lord, they find you. And I said, hopefully they can't read and they still go to hell.
Wow.
If we want to tell wow. the truth. I've had growth since then, but in the moment.
So he also Tina went on a lot about it. Also, Ravy took this photo that we see here. Shouts to Ravy. Put it up,
in
Josh.
Verona.
She's dope. I met her in the street in LA after one of our shoots. Took
That's
a picture
so
with her.
Fire, bro.
That picture is worth more now. Then Jay-Z was talking about why he did the stuff he did, and you can listen to that here.
And we happened upon a brand called Cristal, and you know, we popularized this brand within our community. And then there was those comments in The Economist. I think anyone else could look them up and see what they were. We were happy being consumers of this brand. And, you know, as the universe would have it, an opportunity came right shortly thereafter. And it was just perfect to, you know, build our own thing. The same way, you know, we built Rock Nation. The idea of it was we wanted a record deal. It wasn't this plan to build this this big media company. It was we actually wanted a deal. I wanted a record deal. And when we couldn't get one, we built our own. Similar to, you know, those comments forced us to build our own thing.
So
yesterday it feels very it's a happy day and feel very vindicated from the products and we happen to.
So my initial thoughts were this.
Please.
Kev on Stage Studios.
Oh.
Let me tell you what. We're gonna go to Dream Talk for a minute.
Go ahead. Yeah.
Yesterday we shot 6 episodes of a new show for the app. Patreon was watching some of this with us live. Had a great time. Mm. Love the Patreon. If you are on the Patreon, you get things like that. Yes. Kev on Stage Studios, behind the scenes content. We go live in there, family meetings. It's a whole good fun that most of which never is public to the people. It's only for Patreon. Kev on Stage, if you want to join, got a Discord in there. I had flew my homegirl from Washington in to teach Black girls how to double dutch.
Mm-hmm.
Great. I didn't learn. You'll see the episode. The point is.
I was amazing. Wait till you see.
Oh, my. But the point, we was having so fun.
We were.
Shooting. After which, my homegirl's mom, Keita came, her mom. She fried thighs at my house because she makes the best chicken thighs.
Oh, wow. Mm-hmm.
She came over. I said, hey, Bev. She allows everybody to call her Bev. It's just her thing. Mm-hmm. Her kids, everyone. She just goes by Bev. She came and she cooked chicken thighs to perfection.
Mm-hmm.
I love her. Old black women, they just
know
something in the something in the soul, you know. But Keisha E is the host of this show because if you know the Kev on Stage Studios, our tenet is to create opportunities for underrepresented and underserved and underrepresented talent. Mm-hmm. Angel has got 2 shows coming out on the app.
Thank you.
But Angel's a bigger talent than most of the people, right? So to create a space, literally a building, that houses an opportunity for people to create content, for people like, you know, us to watch.
Yes.
And have, I mean, it's like work, but it is so much fun.
Yes.
When you're creating with your friends or people like you who are all got a common goal. That's where I got the good old days video that I was making today. I was like, I had a great day doing that. I'm doing another one tomorrow. But on the way now, I'm going to my other office to shoot with my good friend Angel and my good friend Joshy.
Yes.
And low-key, I've been working on, like, being in the moment of just like, man.
Good, you know, Kev.
Andy Bernard, Josh. I wish there was a way to know we were in the good old days before we left them. And I know eventually things will get so much where I might not be able to be in all the videos and it'll be more, you know, big producing and all that. But at this moment in time, I'm able to be up in there, pull up, shoot with my son who humbles me.
Very much so.
He said, I mean, I know you're famous, but also... like half of the people, like a billion people don't know who you are. The funniest thing about JoJo is he is so... the thing that makes it so hurtful is he really is not trying to roast you. He is just like, I mean, you get noticed in the airport here and there, but let's not stand on ceremony. Most of the world doesn't know you. Now, PewDiePie and Mr. Beast, they're famous.
You like, okay. Okay.
Thank you guys for coming to Kev on Stage Studios. Okay.
Fried me right on up in my own studio.
Yeah.
First episode there.
First episode in there. And he was low-key like, and even that, right? His eyes, when he got in there, he was like, this is real.
Oh.
This is my dad stuff.
Oh, yes. Here you go, Kev. Here you go.
No. Not all, this is for bonus episode.
It's Kev, but it, I mean,
take it out, Josh.
Just keep it.
Feel your feelings.
Feel them.
Make a space for it. Make a space for it.
To have a place. God dang it.
Go ahead.
Okay, okay. Feel your feelings. We've talked about this. To be able to teach my son how to run a podcast.
Yeah.
He has ads. He has access to equipment. He has me. I was literally teaching, like, okay, stand in the mic this way. These mics are, like, unidirectional. If you go out, you can, he's like, okay, okay. Showing him how to turn on the equipment, turn on the lights, record the audio, record the video. I mean, I can show him how to export and run it into Premiere at 12.
Mm-hmm.
That man not going to have to work for nobody ever. I wish you would. He like, bro, I'm not going to college. Why?
I wish you would work at a job he
doesn't like. I wish you would. Yesterday when I got home from shooting all day, Isaiah was like, me and my friends are writing a neighborhood watch sketch where, well, neighborhood watch sketch where, you know, something's afoot in the neighborhood and we need you to play the dad. And can we shoot it at the studio? And can you get COVID tested because the parents don't want to shoot unless we get COVID tested? I was like, I would love to. That man better not ever work for someone unless he wants to.
Yeah.
Like if I want to, you know, study behind this filmmaker, intern or whatever, like, But working somewhere because you have to, I wish you would. Like, so when Jay-Z says that stuff on my scale, now obviously we ain't sold, you know, this for 25 or none of stuff.
Not selling $23 champagne for $300.
Right. But we are creating these same opportunities for black ownership. And like to Angel show Doggone Crafts and Cocktails, this thing looks pristine. The Ask Auntie Angel show looks amazing.
It does.
Keisha's show looks amazing. And I get as much joy, if not more. Actually, it's definitely more. It's definitely more to give people opportunities and watch them flourish and then watch them go. Like, it's not about even holding them. Like, Angel, within the next, I'd be surprised if it took a year or two. I'd be surprised. She gonna book something and I'm gonna be like, Angel, please just give me 1 hour
you
for the
interview. We'll do a Zoom.
We'll do it in the trailer.
Listen, we'll yesterday. What did I tell you yesterday? I showed up yesterday. Why?
You did.
I showed up.
She showed up because she was my sister.
That's what I said. I said, to anybody else, I'd be like, so sorry. So sorry I cannot come today. So sorry. I've told you from jump, and I'm gonna let you talk. I'm sorry. I told you from jump. When I realized what your vision was, this is prior to you, this is when you were still in racism office. I am down for the vision. Regardless of where I am placed in it, I want you to know, because I see the sincerity of your intentions, that I am down for the vision. And I am so glad that you are recognizing that you, not to say that the days won't get better, but that that you are in good days now.
Yes.
And they can get greater and bigger. Go ahead.
I'm trying to, because you actually, Angel, a lot of people, but Angel a lot, audibly, be like, boy, if you don't appreciate what is happening right now.
Right now.
Like when that kid earlier this week had made me his African-American hero.
That was so dope.
I just be like doing stuff. I don't be thinking about what it means to people. I just be like, okay, this will be dope. This will be dope. This will be dope. Let's get these people. Let's, you know what I'm saying? Like that. And seeing what Jay-Z's doing on a massive scale, we're doing on our, which is the point of Kev on Stage Studio, for digital creators who are not represented and for the black people who want just like fun content.
Yeah.
Like I loved.
Non-traumatic content.
I love. Yes. I loved Malcolm and Marie. I loved Judas and the Black Messiah. But after each, I wanted something light to watch.
You like, where is the heroin?
And I didn't have the same amount of options.
Right.
Of black. And Schitt's Creek's great. It's a very funny show. I enjoy it. But The Office is great too. Those are my like, okay, The Office more than E. Mm-hmm. Those are my go-to like, I just want something light and fun. But and Kev on Stage Studios, I want that to be that.
It's black joy. That it's is
black
what
joy.
You have digitized black joy.
That's what it is.
And I'm here for it. I am here for it. And I know it has to be on a creator level that's wonderful, but also on a father level to be able to be. I mean, I can understand why the child that you have made and are still raising, to see that they are comprehending, even if it's on a smaller level, what is happening. For JoJo to go into a new space and be like, now this is something different.
Because he had never been to the soundstage.
Right, right. That's what you said. And for your oldest son to know, my father has access because of the work that he's been doing. He has access to all these things to make it happen. And so there are things that I want to do that I might be able to ask him. And he will be able to say yes. Like a lot of people can't go to their parents for anything. Like
we've talked about this. Yeah. If a black kid had the idea for GoPro, the white dude, and this is not, I'm not like belittling, this is just the truth. His parents, before he had that idea, they let this man doggone tour the world surfing to find time to find himself.
Yeah.
Amongst that time he was surfing, he said, man, I wish I had a camera that I could put on the edge of this board that could capture it.
Right.
Came up with the idea for GoPro, or I think maybe said he went on his wrist.
Watch.
Either.
Yeah.
Yeah. But then he asked his parents and family and friends that came up with $250,000.
Mm-hmm.
My son could have the idea for that. And amongst my group of friends, I could probably come up with that. If I hit Tobe, Yvonne, my arch nemesis, Jonathan McReynolds, Kirk Franklin, Angel, Joshy,
Sell the Tessie.
You know what I'm saying? But like, I might be able to come up with that. You know, Jeff Bezos, same thing. Like, I think our people have those ideas, but they don't have access to that thing. And if Isaiah and Joe don't do nothing else but be able to do what they want for a living and not have to work a job they don't want to work because of what I've done, my legacy, if I only do that, is enough. If I only do that, but what I'm working to do is so much more.
I feel like that's every parent's dream, is to be able to give their kids access to their opportunities, to be able to give the kids they made with Blue Chew the access to the things that they want in life. And so if you are trying to get access to a good erection, Blue Chew is where you want to get it from. Blue Chew is the final sponsor of this podcast episode. And when I tell you Blue Chew is a good sponsor, because they give you that good. Blue Chew is making waves and bringing more confidence into the bedroom, okay?
Wow.
Blue Chew is a unique online service that delivers the same active ingredients as Viagra, Cialis, but in chewable form at a fraction of the cost. Blue Chew tablets are combat all forms of ED, that's erectile dysfunction, and can help men
gain
extra confidence for when it comes time to perform. Blue Chew is an online prescriptive service, so no visits to the doctor's office, no awkward conversations, and no waiting in the line at the pharmacy. And it ships right to your door in a discreet package. The process is simple. Sign up at BlueChew.com.
BlueChew.com?
Consult with one of their licensed medical providers, and once you're approved, you'll receive your prescription within days. The best part, it's all done online.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. So here's what we want you to do. We've got a special deal for our listeners.
I want you to change that voice right now.
No, I'm giving it to them like this. Try Blue Chew free when you use our promo code SK.
I'm not joining in on
this. Yeah, at checkout. Just pay $5 shipping. That's blue. Promo code SK.
SK.
To receive your first month free. And we thank Blue Chew for sponsoring.
Get the this hard pin you deserve. You deserve an erection.
Erection.
As hard as marble. So, anyway, feelings felt.
Oh, that was beautiful. I'm glad I got to be here in that moment.
Listen, I'm working on it because of therapy and my friends, my wife, Angel, Josh, and my therapist have allowed me to, and allowed me to feel safe doing so.
Yeah.
But, and that's why, like, Kev on Stage Studios, I'm okay with it growing slowly. Somebody was asking me, like, Kev, do you need an influx of cash? We can do marketing. I said, man, none of that is important to me. What's more important is that when people subscribe, they stay.
Yes. Yes, that's
one person at a time. If you take some time and you're like, you know what, I'm gonna check it out. Once you subscribe, you stay because you get one at a time. That's how everything I've done has been built. None of my platforms I shot up quick. It's all been I done seen this dude 6-7 times.
Yeah,
you know, we just are only doing our first wave of content, which was, you know, basically repurpose, keep your distance stuff, Keon Show license. But this next quarter, it's originals. Oh, we get into our sketch show. We're getting into our scripted show. Getting into Angel stuff. Stuff for other people. And I will always leave space to highlight people, even if I know it's not going to yield a whole bunch of subscribers.
Yeah.
You know, if we're like somebody's doing something dope in the black community, we can highlight that.
Yeah.
Even if it's not like, man, like it's okay to do stuff that doesn't have a monetary return that's important to what we do. And that's why I'm willing to take a shot on people, because it's more important to me that if we never get, I don't need 280 million people and I don't recognize the content anymore.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I've done that before. I remember when I, and listen, I don't work at All Def no more. There was times and I was just like, man, I never would do this video ever in my life, but I don't have the control over this.
Yeah.
I'm not proud of this. But I can't, like, stop it. And when you're driven by subscribers and views and numbers, your morality gets lost.
Yeah.
Because you're always chasing. That's how reality shows and The Shade Room, like, people like that. That's how Logan Paul ends up in a suicide forest. Because you're chasing the next big shock thing.
Yeah.
And you're only driven by subscribers and views and numbers. And you don't care how you get them anymore.
Yeah.
I can't live like that.
Right.
Even when I worked at the bank and I was watching people take advantage of people for money. There was, you know, lady next to me was getting people lying on their number. Getting them a house, which was helping them. But then refinancing the house. They weren't understanding. And getting them a loan. They didn't speak English. She did speak the language. I said, man, I live in this community. I don't want to catch nobody at the Puyallup Fairs. Like, you done messed my life up. Like, no. I'd rather not make no bread than to have to look over my shoulder because I done screwed people over. Even one person. You have to fire me before you do that. So, and that's the same thing with my content. For my company, I want to be able to say, I recognize this. I'm proud of this. If it don't do no numbers, I stand by it. So if you want to join us, go to Kev on Stage Studios. Because we are building something slowly, and hopefully one day it's gonna be like, man, Kevin them did this. They sold the Viacom for $3 billion, and I'm gonna make Kev on Stage Studios 2.0 and do it all over again.
Our children are gonna do it. Y'all go ahead and build this thing.
But here's the light thing I wanted to ask you and Josh.
Please.
I have this way down the docket. This is Jay-Z's business. Congratulations to Jay-Z. It's amazing what he's doing.
Yes.
He's buying art, and apparently, filthy rich people pass wealth on through art. This is another topic for another day. But I had this in my docket for a while ago. When you first got your first car, what is the album or albums that you remember bumping the absolute most in your first car? I'll take you guys first and then I'll say mine because I've been talking.
Well, my first
car. And what was the first car?
My first car was a Ford Escort. It was a 91. It was a stick shift. I purposefully got a manual car because that would keep my friends from asking if they could borrow it. I said, I'll get a
car.
That's
hilarious.
Friends are trash. I love it.
Because they will.
I drive stick, so I could have driven your car.
Nah, I would have been mad. I didn't even know how to drive a stick. I burnt out the clutch.
I was going to say.
First time. Yeah, well, they had to teach me. And teaching me on it, we burnt it out. They had to replace it. But I learned. Okay, knew how to drive it eventually. So, but what was so interesting about it, let me tell you why I bought it, and then I'm going to answer your question. I wasn't a Delta yet, but there was a...
Five albums I want to hear.
Okay. You okay. Just wait.
Okay.
I bought the car. I wasn't a Delta yet, but I knew I wanted to be a Delta. There was a broken Delta license plate on the front of the car. And I said, that's a sign that this $700 car is supposed to be mine. It had a tape deck in it, not a CD player.
Woo!
Okay. And there was a tape stuck in it that never came out when I bought it.
Really?
So I never got to play.
Hold on. Would you listen to the radio?
Yep. Couldn't play any music in the thing because the tape deck, the tape was stuck in there. It was stuck. It wasn't coming out. Bought it that way. Tried to take pliers to pull it out. It said, no, ma'am. No, ma'am. Not going anywhere. Not going anywhere. Had no AC, so I would have to drive with my hair over the thing. I would have to drive with my hair over the headrest, so it wouldn't nap up from the sweat in the summer. Because you know, if you sweat on your neck and your hair is pressed, it'll return back to its original state. So yeah, I listened to the radio, is what I did.
Wow. So okay, when you got your first car with music,
Okay, so with first car with music, which that's was my though. Toyota Camry. No, it wasn't a Camry. But anyways, I was listening to Wow Gospel. Don't remember which one it was.
They used to be slapping.
Oh, yes. Wow Gospel. I was listening to Mary Mary nonstop.
Mm-hmm.
Beyonce's album. Where she's like this in hilarious. The chandelier shirt. Where she's like
what
that.
Is that? That's not B-Day.
No.
That's,
That one.
Where she's I can see it. I can't see the right, the.
Dangerously in Love.
Is it?
I think so. That one.
I need to see the cover now.
I was listening to that. And I'm pretty sure that's, maybe I'm going into some other cars. Now I'm at the Kia Sophia. Like this,
yeah. With the gold shirt on.
With the it's like more like a diamond shirt.
Or diamond. Yeah. I definitely said gold and I looked at diamond.
Diamond shirt. Yep. That to the next car, which was my Kia Sophia, I was into Brandy's Full Moon.
Fantastic album. And boy, the singers on Twitter love it.
Yes.
Singers on Twitter, that dog on album is like
fire.
Creme de la creme.
And then not an album, but that was also when I was into listening to the white radio stations. That's when I was in my white girl hard.
No.
Yeah.
NSYNC.
It's just a little crush. Not like I think every time we touch.
Who is that?
I don't remember her name, but I loved it.
I've heard that song a lot.
So that's it. It was Beyonce, Wild Gospel, Mary Mary. Brandy, and then white girl music.
Okay. Joshy, first car, first tune.
My first car was as old as I am. It was a 93 Honda Civic.
Melissa believes that your first car should be as old or older than you.
Oh. That was right on the money.
Yeah. Her first car was the 85 and she was 83.
It was a maroon coupe Honda Civic. Smelt like menthols.
Oh, wow.
The first couple months, I didn't have a CD player in it, so I was burning through the radio. But at that time, I was listening to all things Kanye West, like Graduation, Late Registration. I was just in a Kanye bucket. 50 Cent, specifically G-Unit's Beg for Mercy. That album was out of here. I thought I was tearing the streets up in the suburbs.
Dante came on?
Who? It's not. Joshy, no, I'm sorry, man. I know that's why it's here.
I mean, you literally are talking, Joshy. I'm looking down to see you. I don't see you.
I'm here now. Hey,
okay,
guys.
Okay, okay.
I'm so far behind. Man, Kanye, Lupe Fiasco's Food and Liquor.
Yes, good album.
Man. What else was I listening to?
I was grown. That's what I do know.
Mm-hmm.
When Food and Liquor came out?
No, when you said Kanye, I was like, I was a grown woman.
Oh, man.
Angel been grown since you were 16, though.
You
when you had that
know
half
it.
Up, half down, you look like somebody's mama.
Thomas grown. You hear me?
I mean, that's when Drake was popping off too. Was one side because I didn't get to start driving Drake. Until I graduated
high school.
Yeah,
me neither.
I never needed a ride, so my dad was like, "Why do you need a license?" I'm just like, "Man, I just want to be driving.
I just want to be a man." My first car.
What was it?
Is a gift from a man named Jeff at my church.
My name is Jeff.
He was getting stationed to, in Korea.
Okay.
He had a little red Geo Metro. He was like, this car is not
Geo
worth.
Geo Metro.
Wow.
He said, it's not worth shipping. Do you want it?
That's not how I thought that was going to end.
What'd you think?
It's not worth shipping. I was like, Kev is getting bowed here today.
He's hilarious. It's not worth shipping. He was like, oh man, you know what? You want a car, you can have it.
Wow.
This car did not, the driver's door did not close.
Mm-hmm.
I had to tape red, it was a red Geo Metro hatchback, two door. I had to tape red duct tape along the sides to get in or to keep the door closed. I literally, when I first drove it, I turned left to go into the freeway, the door opened. Closed it. I had to hang my arm over the thing just to keep the door closed. Mm-hmm. And I realized what happened. I thought I just didn't do it the first day. And I was like, oh no, this door. He never told me. Like, Jeff, you could have told me. I wouldn't care.
Right.
I obviously didn't have money to get it fixed. So I put a little string in there, tied it tight. So it wouldn't open. Sealed that window. And we was rolling.
You
used to have to open the door for Melissa. She was like, oh, how sweet. I was like, excuse me, gotta get in. One of my first jokes on stage was that. Used to kill at that time.
That's a good joke.
But the album. Ty Tribbett.
Yes.
The Life album. What was it called, Life? Ty Tribbett, first album where everything is on.
What do you think?
Oh, my God. What's a... Ty Tribbett. Oh, my God. Why am I... blanking.
The Bloody Wind? Fresh?
It is Life. I was right. It's called Life.
Life. Yep. There it is.
The song I was talking about. No way I can make it. And do 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 do. Okay. That album, which I love, by the way, which is the album that I credit bringing me back to gospel music because it was boring to me for a while. Mary Mary Invincible album is the number one.
That
is a fantastic,
amazing
album, front to back.
Yes, sir.
That thing is slappers only. Tone Out the Box, which is top five gospel albums to me, Kevin, of all time. Debate Your Mom. I love it. It's a lot of songs, most of which are good. Kirk Franklin, The Rebirth of Kirk Franklin.
You were only listening to gospel.
People think I'm joking. I could not purchase in my, like I was able to, my spirit would not allow me to purchase anything but gospel music. I would listen to non-gospel on the radio. People would, you know, all that stuff, but I couldn't, I could not.
Oh, wow. Buy.
I remember, very funny story. One of my, the other album was a burnt CD of the Jackson 5, its greatest hits. Melissa's mom, very saved at the time, we all were. Picked up my pastor in a ride. I used to listen to this burnt CD of Jackson 5. Oh, baby, give me one more chance. Show you that I love you. Won't you please help me back in your heart? First of all, Michael Jackson, even as un baby boy, that boy was singing.
Oh, no. He outsang his older version of himself.
As a baby?
Yeah, Little Michael Jackson.
Little Michael Jackson.
I don't know many people who can sing better than Little Michael Jackson.
Okay, now.
I know old Michael Jackson couldn't. Old Michael Jackson didn't have nothing. He had his whispers, okay? But Little Mikey?
What's the one where he was just, I was like, okay, boy. What's the slow song that he...
When I
that's what it was.
I treated you bad. Come on, switch the key. Yes.
And wrong I did. Girl sins. Is it? Was it live on the Ed Sullivan Show when he was going on?
I don't know. I've just only heard it.
I got to hear it now.
What was the story though? Finish the story.
Oh, I'm sorry, I got distracted. Melissa's mom was mad at me because you played the Jackson 5 for the man of God. You let him hear. I was like, I am certain. Like I really didn't understand
It's the number one song.
It was
on
like
the radio.
The Jackson 5.
Right.
I know he grew up listening to this.
It's like the Disciples. It's all this.
It's literally
not underground music.
Like, who's loving you? She was like, for the pastor, you switch it out.
You take it out.
10 years later, she picked me up. She had T.I. in her car.
Rubber band, man. Rubber band, wow, man. That's literally, a Dallas band. Like, 45 in my, oh, who I be. I love the song.
Okay.
Yeah, that's how they'd be, though.
Now we have to hear it, Angel, because.
He sings. You hear me?
This boy, I see why he was the youngest, and Joe was like, shut up, Tito and Jermaine. Can y'all do this?
That's you.
If you can't do this, hush.
Shut it.
Come on, run.
You better sing, Michael Joseph.
Come on.
Ain't he singing, Angel? Life without love? Oh, yeah, I'm early. Who he singing to at this little age?
Listen, that's when you can sing, when you don't know what you're talking about.
Justin Bieber.
You hear them notes?
This boy was going ham.
Michael. These notes.
You can't teach that.
No, that's God given. Like what I love. Boom, 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 boom. I don't think, choir. I don't think.
Oh, oh, this is getting flagged.
Oh, my.
This might get restricted, actually.
Oh, my.
They don't play with Michael Jackson.
Do you only?
We'll find out.
He's like,
come on and take it, girl! Cause what? And you who? Should never wonder or worry your pretty little head. Worry
about what I do.
This is a child, Joshua. A child.
Wonder. Come on.
I get it. That boy was living in your house, and Joe Jackson was like, oh, we getting out of Gary. We are getting TF out of Gary, Indiana.
Then my kids better not show me no potential. They better not. Right now, they banking off of nice personalities, but they show me some talent.
Listen, when the kids were young, I remember, I said this before, I'm going to say it again. I'm going to say that all the time. Joe DiVola at Awesomeness TV. When Isaiah and Josiah were doing their stuff, he said, JoJo? That's the one. Isaiah is great. He's talented. He's a straight man. JoJo used to piss me the off. I mean.
Yeah.
But when that boy felt like doing it.
It's good.
That boy also is almost a dog on natural born podcaster. Mm-hmm. I'd be literally having a conversation with a 12-year-old. He is so much like Melissa. That boy do not want to get off topic. We talk about being famous. We gonna talk about being famous.
You're not about to be going chasing bunnies around the forest. Chasing
bunnies. We ain't finna be doing all that stuff. Melissa too. Love our Kevin. We're off. Mm-hmm. Joe be like same little face right here. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Same face. He's like, okay, we'll talk about another episode. He knows his ads. On this episode we just did, he was like, I helped him with the ad. He was like, I saw the time. Which Melissa be like, I saw it. Around 20, 30 minutes, he'd be like, all right, that's about it. Y'all, okay, you have anything else? I'd be like, boy, you was your mama's son.
He's like, I got this. Don't worry.
I mean, natural born. Mm-hmm. Natural born. But anyway, I love y'all. We got to go. I appreciate everything you guys have done. Joshua, edit me out of crying.
Leave it, but zoom in slowly.
We will see the Patreon. We are actually shooting a new show on Patreon for the app. That is interactive for Patreon only. We're shooting an improv show on Friday where if your Patreon is actually going to be a part of the show, picking out the titles and the things that we actually do, mm-hmm. and you'll get to watch it live. It'll later come out on the app. It'll be integrated with the audience's suggestions in. So if you're on Patreon, you actually get to be a part of that shooting this Friday. If you're not, you get to watch it on the app. If you don't have either of those, then, you know, God bless you. Hopefully we get to see you another time. God bless you.
We'll see you at the
God keep you. See you at the conference.
Bye.
Here's another thing of fire. Here's another one. Here's another thing of fire. Here's another one. Here's another one. Here's another thing of fire. Fire, here's another bang of fire. With my boy Kev on stage, and that chick Angel.